Hey guys, it's Lizzie. So this video is relationship advice for anyone who is dating someone who has bipolar. The reason I wanted to make this is because I've been getting so many emails, Twitter DMs, Facebook messages lately from people who are dating someone who's bipolar, and when I'm reading the situation that's happening, I'm like, me too, same, definitely done that to someone before. The same issues are coming up in each relationship because of the bipolar, so I just wanted to make a whole video explaining our perspective so that if you're dating someone who's bipolar, you can understand why we're behaving the way that we are.
She really doesn't like to wait, not really into hesitation. Pulls me in enough to keep me guessing.
Also, I'm gonna link below and up here my playlist to all my videos about bipolar disorder. So if you want to understand it more, those will help you out.
Your reliability, you're a little much
But I
for
know that people who watch this who don't know anything else about bipolar might stigmatize us as being people who are really impulsive or hurt people or lead people on. So I wanted to say that people with bipolar who have treated their bipolar, gone to therapy, are taking medicine, taking it seriously, I think they may actually be better in relationships than the average person because in therapy, we're forced to talk through all of our emotional issues throughout our entire life. And we have to learn self-control and the ability to decipher between different types of emotions before making a decision or before saying something. People with bipolar have the potential to have really healthy, normal relationships. But if someone has been newly diagnosed within the past few years and doesn't understand they're bipolar yet and is not self-aware, that's when all of these issues can crop up. So a huge part of this video is if you're dating someone who's bipolar, they might not be realizing that some of their thoughts and emotions are coming directly from the mood episodes.
'Cause I can change my mind each day. I didn't mean to try you on, but I still know your birthday.
So the most common question that I have been getting is, you're describing her as pushing you away or like randomly cutting you off, or you feel like she suddenly doesn't want to be with you, suddenly isn't attracted to you, and you're really confused and you just didn't see it coming at all. This is a thing that happens.
I know that you're afraid, I'm gonna walk away. It's time to feel and face, it's time to feel.
So with bipolar, when we're really manic, it's like you have this emotional high towards everything in your life. So, the way you feel when you first start dating someone, that infatuation rush, it's like a euphoric type feeling. We feel that towards everything in our life when we're hypomanic or manic. Hypomania and mania also involves hypersexuality. So we will feel extremely attracted to you and like we really want to be with you. We're very passionate and intense and we'll be very verbally affirming when we're more manic. We'll want to be around you all the time. Some people, when they're manic, will get more angry or irritable, but a lot of people, mania is they're just so social, very extroverted, very attracted to you. They're so excited for the relationship. And from your perspective, it will seem like the relationship's going really well. And I want to clarify that just because someone is hypomanic or manic and they feel so much more towards you and act way more into you when they're in that state, it does not mean that all of those emotions are fake. So, yes, I think sometimes when someone's manic, they can feel attracted to someone who they don't even want to be with. Like, one time I accidentally dated one of my guy friends who I didn't even like because I was manic. And I've even felt like attracted to, like I wanted to kiss some of my guy best friends when I've been really manic. And then when I'm not manic, it's like definitely don't want to date them, like not attracted to them in that way at all. So sometimes mania produces emotions that are fake and that are only because of the mood episode. But most of the time, when someone is hypomanic or manic and they feel really attracted to you, that's just exemplifying the normal emotions that they feel towards you in the relationship. So, this is a really long explanation, I know. So, when someone's manic, they're really, really into you, they feel so attracted to you, they're so confident in the relationship. From their perspective, there aren't any problems in the relationship, they love what's happening. Then, if they go down to normal or they go into depression, the way they feel in the relationship completely changes. And it can feel like a switch just went off in their brain. They can wake up the next day, they're no longer manic, suddenly they feel like they've lost all feelings for you, they feel insecure in the relationship, they see all the problems in the relationship, they feel like they want to break up with you, they're not attracted to you, they're actually really annoyed by you, and when we're in depression, we can even feel like you don't want to be with us. And this doesn't even have to be like full out episodes, it can be like a slight depression or a slight manic can cause these exemplifying emotional changes in how we feel in the relationship. That could finally fix me, looking at my history, I'm bad in love. And the hardest part is that we'll feel like you don't care about us. When we're in depression, we'll feel like you don't want to be with us, you're not attracted to us, you don't care about us. I don't know why, but that happens in depression. And what's the strangest thing is I don't feel these changes towards any other relationship in my life, towards my friends, my family, but for some reason in a romantic relationship, it's completely different, and we can go from feeling so secure and confident about the relationship, so attracted to you, to nothing, and to we really want to break up with you and you don't want to be with us, and it can happen just because of our brain chemistry changing overnight. And so like one of the messages I got, someone was saying, whenever she becomes depressed, she doesn't want to spend time with me, she pushes me away, I really want to help her. All she does is go to her friends about her problems and she doesn't come to me. And the reason is because when we switch into depression, how we feel about our friends doesn't really change, but how we feel about the relationship will change. And people who don't even have bipolar will break up with someone because they say, I just don't love you anymore, or like, I don't feel the same way, you know? Everyone goes off of emotions in relationships, you have to. And so when these dramatic emotional changes are happening for no reason, it's very difficult to know what to do. You want to make sure the other person feels emotionally secure in the relationship. And so how do you explain that you don't want to be in the relationship anymore for no reason? We're just hoping that it will go away soon and we'll go back to feeling secure in the relationship. So that's why we're not talking to you about it. So I think that just be aware that this is a thing that happens in bipolar. It doesn't necessarily have anything to do with you or how you're being in the relationship. It might not be your fault at all. It could just be their brain chemistry changing. So I think you need to be someone who's very confident and will not get easily offended, meaning do not take it personally. So talk to your girlfriend or wife, ask her if she can relate to what I explained. Make her feel like you're not gonna get hurt or offended or be made to feel insecure in the relationship just because she feels like she wants to break up with you. I think that the worst thing is if she keeps all of those emotions to herself and doesn't verbalize them to you, she can ruminate on them and then come to a conclusion like, oh, I should break up with him because this is hurting him, I can't decide on how I feel. You know what I mean? And then it can seem like she's impulsively cutting you off, but actually it can be building up after a long time of constantly having these changes in how she feels. And I think that most people with bipolar, the mood episodes will last for several months. So you'll be manic or hypomanic for like 6 months and then be in depression for 8 months. There's also something called rapid spiraling bipolar where every couple days you can switch between depression and mania. But I've found from most people I've talked to with bipolar, like through my YouTube or who I've met, there can be these dramatic mood shifts all throughout the week. Like currently I'm in more of a hypomanic state, but some days I'll be in depression for a day, or I'll be really manic one day. And even if someone is on medicine or is in more of a normal state, they can still feel these emotional extremes that can make them feel like the relationship is really, really unstable when maybe there really isn't that much wrong with it. Sorry that I can't believe that anybody ever really starts to fall. I really recommend listening to a song by Halsey. She has bipolar disorder. If you want to get in the mind of someone with bipolar, listen to her music. There's a lyric in it that goes, sorry to my unknown lover, sorry that I can't believe that anyone really starts to fall in love with me. And I think that with bipolar, everyone with bipolar has kind of had a thought at some point in their diagnosis that no one would really want to be with us because we have such a chaotic brain and broken brain almost. And I personally don't feel this insecurity on a daily basis. It doesn't really affect me, but it's something I've thought. And I think that someone with bipolar who's been recently diagnosed may feel very insecure about it and feel like no one would actually want to be with them, or maybe they don't deserve to be loved by someone. And I know that's really screwed up thinking. Like, I personally don't believe that, and I don't think anyone with bipolar should believe that, but I think we do have the tendency to feel like we don't want someone to get that close to us. And part of this as well is that bipolar is extremely hellish, painful, awful, disorienting. You completely lose your identity a lot. You get brain damage. You have suicidal thoughts. It's the worst thing. And so I personally do not want to be in a relationship because I don't want anyone to get close enough to me to have to feel everything that I've felt and to kind of vicariously experience some of it. So tend to be extremely empathetic, and so we feel other people's emotions and other people's experiences, and sometimes we might overanalyze the extent to where other people will experience our emotions. Does that make sense? It's kind of a protective thing where we don't want you to get too close to us because we know that we'll hurt you because the bipolar is hurting us so much. And this is something I've felt since high school, and probably a lot of people with bipolar do, where I feel like I am hurtful and I need to protect people from myself. Before I even knew I was bipolar, I had this type of thinking. I don't really know how to explain it, but I think that that will cause us to, like, even if we want to be in a relationship, kind of push you away sometimes because we want to protect you from us. The song Demons by Imagine Dragons really touches upon this theme. Don't get too close. It's dark inside. It's where my demons hide. I want to hide the truth. I want to shelter you, but with the beast inside, there's nowhere we can hide. And then the lyric I relate to the absolute most towards anyone I care about. Your eyes, they shine so bright. I want to save that light. I can't escape this now unless you show me how. And so it's like we need people in our lives to help us and to be close to us, but at the same time, we want to protect people and we don't want anyone to get close enough to us to see how bad it is. Someone who was messaging me about their girlfriend, or I think she broke up with him, he said that she kept saying, I want to protect you, I'm trying to protect you, and he didn't understand what that meant. And I hope now you understand what we mean by trying to protect people. And I think that especially if you verbalize to them in a harsh way that the way they're behaving in changing how they feel about you or pushing you away sometimes, if you've communicated that that is hurting you and you want it to stop, then they're gonna be like, okay, like, I can't stop changing how I feel about you because it's literally beyond my control, so I will break up with you to protect you so you don't have to be hurt by me anymore. And I think that it's not fair for the person with bipolar to decide to protect you. So you need to verbalize very directly that you're okay with being hurt by their bipolar. Like, have a conversation and tell them that you care about them, love them enough, and you want to be hurt by it. You want to help them. You don't care how awful it is. You don't care if you have to see how painful it is. Something else is that when someone is in depression, they will have no energy, not want to reach out to you at all. And this is kind of the same thing where, like, don't get offended by things. Like, when I'm in really severe depression, like, I sleep through events. If my friends invite me to something, I don't want to go. And it's not personal at all. It's just like we're in depression and we have literally no energy to do anything, and sometimes we don't want to be around people. But I think that if that's really hurting your relationship, just tell her that it's hurting the relationship, like, talk to her about it. When I'm in depression, I do not push away my friends, and so I think it's completely possible in depression for her to keep reaching out to you anyways, even though she feels nothing towards you and feels like she doesn't want to be with you. Ultimately, relationships are about caring about the other person's best interest, regardless of how you feel, showing through actions that you care. This isn't just a problem for people with bipolar when they're in depression episodes. Like, when someone's married to someone, you're gonna have fluctuations in how you feel about them. And so I think it's not an excuse to say, oh, I'm in depression right now, I'm gonna put zero effort into this relationship. Yes, be patient with them, but at the same time, since knowing I've been bipolar, I was in a situation where I was talking to a guy, and when I was in, like, the depression, like, I didn't want to talk to him at all. I didn't care about him. But I forced myself to talk to him anyways, to reach out to him anyways, because I knew the emotions would eventually come back. I don't know if that makes sense, but we're fully capable of putting effort into a relationship, caring about you, even when we feel like we don't care. Number three, why would you? Who you swore that you would be? I have questions, I got questions. people with bipolar tend to be very intuitive and almost like prophetic and psychic. And so we might see a problem in the relationship that you don't see right now. And so if you feel like she is impulsively breaking up with you, it could be because she sees actual problems in the relationship that you just happen to not see. And for some reason, your communication isn't working out well enough to where she doesn't feel safe communicating that to you. And that's the other thing as well. Just because she feels like she wants the relationship to end or she feels like you don't care about her, it might not necessarily be 100% just caused by her brain. It could be you're doing something that's really hurting her. And because she's bipolar, she's exemplifying it in her mind. I've gotten messages from people who are bipolar who, like, every time if they ever get mad at their significant other for doing something or they have a problem in the relationship, the boyfriend is always like, oh, is it your bipolar acting up? Oh, are you manic today? And like, that will definitely cause them to break up with you because you're basically saying all of their emotions are invalid and anything you do isn't wrong, it's just their brain. So definitely also take some serious self-reflection and understand that what you've done to hurt them will cause them to react in a certain way. So frustrating. Some people in my life do this to me. Anytime I actually get upset about something, they blame it on my bipolar and they think that they're not doing anything wrong. It's so stigmatizing and it's very frustrating. Everyone else is allowed to get angry sometimes. Everyone else is allowed to call out other people for being awful. But for some reason, when someone has bipolar, if they ever get frustrated or angry at you, you automatically think it's them and not you. And even if they do happen to be manic when they are getting angry at you, it could still be justified and still be something that you're doing wrong. I think that mania just allows us to be more expressive and more impulsive with what we say, but mania is not like creating emotions out of nowhere. Like, there's always a catalyst for why we're reacting in a certain way, and it just becomes exemplified and we become a lot more honest about how we feel because we're manic. I need to let you go. Your eyes, they shine so bright. I wanna say that line. And something else that I've heard from people who are bipolar that's very common is whoever they're dating, they don't believe that they're bipolar or they don't take the diagnosis that seriously. Like, they kind of think like, oh, like, she's just bipolar. Like, they don't understand that it's a serious medical condition. Take it very, very seriously. There's a 1 in 4 successful suicide rate amongst people who are bipolar, and most people with bipolar will attempt suicide at some point in their life. And when we're manic, we can do things that can accidentally kill us as well or hurt other people. If someone's been officially diagnosed by a psychiatrist, assume that it's really bad, and just because you can't see the manifestations of it doesn't mean that it's not really awful and affecting them every single day. For some reason, if you're undermining how bad it is, like, they're not gonna trust you as someone they can openly talk to about their bipolar, and they're not gonna invite you in to help them understand their emotions. That was everything I wanted to share. I hope this was really helpful. Comment below if you have bipolar with any more advice for anyone who's reading through the comments. I love you guys so much, and I will see you in my next video. Bye! Your eyes, they shine so bright.